seas. I want your everything as long as it's free. I want your love.
Live from the Heritage Bank Center here in Cincinnati, Ohio, we welcome you to TPGW Diamonds Holy Matrimony. Hello there, everyone. My name is Zahiah Morgan. I am one of the official commentators here for TPGW Diamonds alongside Mr. HitKid Worldwide.
Pulled out from my general manager duties to be here, but it is a special occasion.
And one of the newer comers here to the TPGW commentary desk, none other than one Mr. Arin Michaels.
Hey, everybody.
And this one is a very special one because it is coming off the heels of one MTB and his lovely fiance's wedding. So we want to give a little bit of a congrats to them for their holy matrimony.
And congratulations! I'm happy it didn't turn out like the Rory's Wall Reading in 1999.
That is very true. Fortunately for us, we have been given a gift of our own, a bit of a wedding gift, because we have four Diamonds Championship matches on the line tonight, including our main event, which is going to be champion versus champion, as the current Diamonds World Champion Toni Storm goes one-on-one against the current Queens of Wrestling Tartarus Champion Jennifer Cruel.
Be a hell of a night.
Absolutely. So with that, with that said, let's go down to the ring and start off this wondrous night.
Scheduled for one fall is for the TPGW Intercontinental Championship.
Well, we're going to start things off with the Intercontinental Championship being defended here on Diamonds. Here's the woman. Here's a woman that.
Jesus Christ.
Along with another woman behind her that I kind of need an explanation on what the hell is going on here.
What the hell happened to this woman?
I have no idea. You can also hear in the crowd that there's not many cheers today.
Oh no, she's getting booed out the fucking building here in Cincinnati.
Yeah.
It was back at Christmas at the Garden, where it was Ivy Embers taking on Akira Yukimura for the Queens of Wrestling Championship. And, you know, while it was a great match, it was back and forth, but out of nowhere, here comes both Kitty White and Beryl Bedlam to interrupt the match, to get the match thrown out, but they attack both Akira and Ivy, which is pretty much the lead into this match right now.
Beryl has skated quite clearly. She's coming for, you know, Akira Yukimura and that Queens of Wrestling title.
I mean, alongside Satan's Ballroom, it seems like we've got a very dangerous new faction here in the Diamonds division, to say the least.
Here's a little, what the fuck happened to Kitty White?
At this point, who knows?
Do I even know you anymore, if I'm allowed to say that? I think Sai would agree with that.
I think it's pretty safe to say if we ever truly knew her at all.
That is true.
Yeah.
Understand they call themselves the Anti-Empire. What entity are you trying to take over then?
Well, you gotta remember that Akira herself calls herself the Empress. They might be looking to take down that empire for all we know.
Who's the champ?
But right now,
the Embers.
You're gonna have to worry about this woman who is damn sure looking for some revenge of her own. Ivy had the opportunity of a lifetime back at the Christmas special, and it was just taken away from her in one swift motion by Jenny Blight, Beryl Bedlam, and Satan's Ballroom. Mm-hmm. Now her title. Oh, go ahead.
No, go on.
Now it is her turn. She has to defend her belt. It doesn't really favor her, but I don't think she could really care about the circumstances. She just wants a piece of Kitty White here in this match.
Then there's going to be bad blood in this feud.
Oh, the main motivator behind this match is revenge, ladies and gentlemen.
Introducing the challenger from San Jose, California, Kitty White! And her opponent from Salt Lake City, Utah, she is the TPGW Intercontinental Champion, Ivy Ember!
Referee taking the belt. Now it has to be said, Kitty has been targeting Akira since she lost to the Empress back at California Beach Bash, and now she's
Look at this army Kitty White has produced. Beryl Bedlam, we all know how much of a bruiser powerhouse, you know, ruthless intent Beryl Bedlam has. And now you have Jen and Kirara. You know, Satan's Ballroom?
Mm-hmm. And to boot, Kitty's been calling herself the Anti-Empress.
There seems to be a bit of an obsession here for Kitty White when it comes to, you know, beating Akira, it seems.
Look at the hairstyle of the Mello, Zahiah.
Yeah.
And the attire. Zahiah.
Yeah,
he's similar to Akira Yukimura's attire.
You know what? You got a point there, I was about to say.
It's kind of obsessive, to say the least. Jesus.
Oh my goodness!
Hair toss.
You have to wonder when the fuse really snapped with Kitty. Was it Akira loss, or was it... Dare I say everything which happened, you know, when, you know, during her hunt for the TPGW Diamonds World title there? Infamous matches with Revy, as we all remember.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Jesus.
When did that switch really break, in a sense?
You know, there's a lot of things that have to come into question when it comes to this whole change of character for Kitty White. She now goes for the cover here, all ready to look.
One more one.
Could have even been a matches with Celeste Mira.
Up in the corner, big time clothesline. To Ivy, and there's a big time drop kick to the chest.
That was a huge step up drop kick, Jeff Hardy style, as you were just about to mention.
Yes.
Aaron.
Yeah.
Cover here.
Ivy with the get the fuck off me kick out.
Yeah, Ivy's gonna have to be very careful because it's bad enough. Oh! She's going up against someone as unpredictable as Kitty, but when you got someone like Beryl watching your back now, this just makes that task a whole lot more difficult.
Keep an eye on Beryl,
struck it down to the steps!
Exactly, like, oh my, Jesus Christ. She's fighting back.
Referee still counting. Oh my goodness!
Get into the steps.
Kitty has to get Ivy back into the ring. She can't win the belt off of the count out. There you can see Ivy just ran into Beryl.
She will give Kitty time.
Oh, wait a second.
Oh, Ivy!
Ivy!
Embers Wing!
Embers Wing.
And now I'm looking to end it!
She's going for it.
No!
Straight head first!
One! Oh. Two!
Two!
The Phoenix! The Phoenix down! Embers Wing right into the Phoenix down, and it's still not enough. Oh, wait, no. Pinning now. Pin! Takama! Into a pin! No!
Just with, now you've got one.
Yeah, gotta be thinking that Kitty is a tough one.
Oh!
Jesus
Christ. She went in Burning Phoenix, and she missed it.
Top package!
One.
Two.
Two.
No.
You know what? You absolutely know what?
Listen, I'm not keeping that arsehole on my mind, okay?
All right.
And plus, it's MTV's wedding day. I'm gonna keep the place classic for us.
Oh, she's going for Embers Wing again.
Wing!
Embers Wing. Stunner.
What the hell in the
hell? Hey.
Not the problem.
What do you think? How do you think the Mello feels about all this? About this, knowing that his sister is.
Mello don't do shit.
What? We
Mello
all know.
Don't do shit.
We all know the Bedlam's kind of just, you know, they solve their own problems.
Listen. Let me say it like this, and Zahiah will understand this. Me and my brother have gone into so much trouble because my brother's done shit without his knowledge, and I've done shit without his knowledge. If you get what I'm saying. Bella just returned the ring, and I believe she is getting thrown out.
Well, good on the rest.
Yeah, he did. Bella getting tossed out of this match.
But as I was going to say to Aaron, and here's the truth, and Zahiah will understand this, siblings do all their own shit. It's pretty much the same in the Bedlam family compared to my family. We usually deal with our own shit. It's not really a place.
Oh no, here comes the twist of fate!
What's the fate?
Twist of fate.
Could we have a new Intercontinental Champion right here now? Look, it comes down to the fact that sometimes you gotta let your siblings make their own decision, make their own mistakes.
Yes.
They gotta be their own people sometime.
And we'll chastise each other for it. Can I be clear?
What the hell?
That's a holy
joke! Oh, goodness!
Holy joke!
Jesus
Christ! I got a new champion!
Oh, Jesus.
And City laughs at her.
Just like that! We've got a new TPGW Intercontinental Champion in Kitty White!
Looks like the locker room has just been put on notice even more. Look, and her new mission is called the Dragon's Demise.
Oh, wonderful. Oh. That's great.
Does she really want to take this spot with Akira?
That's kind of petty.
Like, all I'm going to say is, how you know for a standout you spoke with Akira goes?
Look,
here's your winner and the new TPGW Intercontinental Champion, Kenny. What?
Whether you or not I think she should or shouldn't is kind of mute at this point. The fact is that she has chosen to pick that path, and in doing so, the Anti-Empire have now picked up their first championship. Uh-oh.
She's dead.
Oh, no.
She's dead.
Uh-oh.
That's not Akira's music, but you brought up this woman earlier.
Oh, my.
Diamonds!
Oh, this makes it worse because Beryl is already sent back! Oh, wait a second, there she is! Beryl coming back! Oh, goodness!
Someone dropped. I Celeste. Whoa.
Celeste Amira! Take it! Oh my gosh! Oh, Kitty's getting out of dodge.
Kitty's running.
She wants absolutely nothing to do with Celeste at this moment. Oh, wait.
She brought him back. I think she brought him back going back for a title, and Celeste is already in the ring.
Kitty White does not want those problems, at least not for tonight. But sooner or later, reality's gonna catch up to her, and that reality is in the form of Celeste Mir, because I think this woman wants her in the worst way right now.
Oh, I agree.
Kitty, you better beware. Celeste is gonna go after your head.
Not even Intercontinental Champion for 2 minutes and already has the biggest target on her head.
Indeed.
To our second title match of the night, this time for the Genesis Championship.
Keeping that momentum going.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. As you hear the music, it could only mean one woman, and that woman right there is Samantha Hart, former WFS Uncaged Champion, former ZCW Women's Tag Team Champion, but is now looking to get some more gold around her waist in the form of the Genesis title.
This has some payback on the mind here as well.
Absolutely.
Into Events of Revolution.
I mean, between all the Vixens of Carnage shenanigans, them. Oh my goodness!
Jesus Christ!
You kind of figured that this one was coming sooner rather than later. And with tonight basically being Champions Night, Samantha Hart has the biggest opportunity of them all to take that Genesis title away from Alicia.
Mm. Yeah, but the question
is... the big question.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Because if there's one thing about we've come to know about the fucking Schultz is that they are stubborn.
Yeah, that's true.
They don't give up too easy. They don't give up that easily.
They're stubborn to the word life itself, if I'm allowed to be honest.
Yep. You know, obviously, Mikasa is currently going through some stuff, but as of right...
But on that shit, well, that's technically my fault.
Look, I'm just bringing it up, it has to be said.
Yeah,
but Mikasa Schultz, Alicia Schultz walking down to the ring with the Genesis Championship. We always brought up how it was usually Tia or Mikasa that was normally the main front, you know, either like singles championships or tag team championships. This woman right here has really made her case here as one of the leading Schultzes by gaining the TPGW Genesis Championship back at Revolution last year.
Indeed.
But now here comes the real test. It's one thing to get the belt, it is a whole other thing to defend it. And it's a whole other thing to defend it against a former world champion in her own right, in Samantha Hart.
I'm pretty much... You've got to get the mindset to Samantha, okay? Doing all the shit, as I said, the Schultzes are too stubborn, and they stubborn to the word of death, if you might say, and all the shit that's going around TPGW, outside of TPGW. But when it's come to recent times in TPGW, the Schultzes have had Samantha Hart's number.
They have.
Indeed.
Is Alicia gonna have it tonight? We're gonna have to find out as we go down to ringside!
Introducing the challenger from Indianapolis, Indiana. She is the collegiate, Samantha Hart! And her opponent from Detroit, Michigan, representing the Vixens of Carnage. She is the TPGW Genesis Champion, Alicia Schultz!
B. big-time match here for Alicia Schultz, probably one of the biggest in her career thus far, defending that Genesis Championship against one Samantha Hart here on Diamonds 18.
And here we go.
Oh, goodness!
Half the game.
Let's see Alicia not wasting any time here. Going straight after Samantha. But I don't know if you want to bum rush Samantha Hart. Go after her immediately. That doesn't seem to be the smartest strategy.
Samantha's a striker. You need to remember this. She's a powerful striker. She's a brawler. She likes a fight. The Schultzes, the entire family, you could say, are fucking, you know, nutty at some points. Oh, nice kick.
We gotta also remember one of the main people that helped train Samantha, you know, her longtime frenemy, to say the very case, Tia Benson.
Superflex back in the ring.
So
you don't know if the friends or enemies, change from company to company.
It really does.
It's very on and off, basically.
They are the Sammy and Kevin, female version of Sammy and Kevin, within Gold Wrestling. Someone to tell me I'm wrong.
Goodness! Oh. Cradle shock from Alicia!
I was thinking, and hopefully no one takes this the wrong way, I was thinking more lines of your brother and Charles. More or less.
I guess in a sense that could be true. Okay.
Yeah, that is well.
Oh, wait a sec. Samantha, looking for the drone fire on Alicia!
And Samantha Hart.
I don't have that song anymore. Oh, goodness!
Yeah, he has a better theme, to be fair.
I guess that's depending on your point of view.
Well,
are you really going to argue that theme compared to the current theme he has?
Alicia's going...
I like the Dennis.
Oh, come on.
It's so meme worthy.
Back and forth.
Shoulder thrust. Ramp. And she has a belly to belly.
Kick to the back.
And
Samantha just telling her to come on.
See the confidence. Former uncaged champion on full display. Wait a second, Alicia! Destino!
No!
One enough.
One.
Whoa! Only a one count.
Yep. That's Samantha Hart's toughness.
Coming out on full display. Jawbreaker. Big punch!
Oh. That was a straight right hand right on the button.
Damn. Whoa.
I'm in.
Suplex.
Signature German suplexes here.
Oh.
From Samantha Hart, and she's not letting go!
You mentioned before about her relationship with Tia Benson, right?
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, goodness gracious!
Damn. Welcome back.
Cover.
One.
No. Samantha Hart was listening to that acclaimed music video on Rampage this week, it seems.
well, to be fair, she probably was doing, considering, you know, the Schultz family's always had that connection to people like that.
True. Whoa!
Like,
and now, somewhere in some universe, I'm going to get a message now saying to fuck off.
Oh, wait a minute! Whoa!
Samantha looking to beat the guff out of the Schultz.
Damn it.
You know I'm right!
You know you're gonna get tons of messages from the Schultz's number one fanboy Cody after this is over.
Yeah, we're gonna get a year for
it. That's all you can do these days is be a virgin and message considering Jebediah took his girl.
That's dick. Oh, wait, here we go. German suplexes again.
Oh,
there's no, fifth one, sixth,
number six.
But you can see Samantha getting tired out as this match continues.
Nice quick arm throw though.
And Alicia hitting that Rainmaker. Wait, what the? Oh! What a bridge! What a bridge! Dude. Whoa!
Well, Spanish went schoolgirl and it gets two.
Backs it up. It's to the corner. Oh, smack that hazard. Oh! No!
Another shoulder into the turn.
Ring Coast City.
Tossed her right into that ring post, and now this could be exactly what Samantha needed. Goes for the cover. One! Oh, no! Actually, a one count from Alicia this time.
I was close to two, but not even.
I have no idea what Samantha is trying to do here. She already tried to go up top once before.
And we could. Oh, she overthought it. And she.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa! A counter!
Uh-oh, another counter.
What in the world could Samantha have planned here for Alicia?
Great question. Do people call her Sam or just Samantha?
Yeah, I've never called. I've never heard anyone call her Sam before.
Alright, I'm just asking. I don't. Oh!
Everyone calls her Samantha. None of us have ever called her Sam.
Oh! No.
We all call you a faces if I'm right. I'd
value not being tossed like Alicia just got tossed there. Two! Three. No!
I agree with you.
Samantha could just be moments away from putting this one away. Oh, looking for the heart attack!
Heart attack.
Got it! She's not done!
She's not done.
Double up! Two heart attacks!
In a row.
Dear.
Alicia's still getting up!
Alicia was getting up. I'm surprised she didn't go for a cover straight away, though.
Look at this. Look at the uppercuts from Samantha!
You gotta remember, both of them are no slouches. Ah!
Big time uppercuts from corner to corner. Drop kick!
That was a flush drop kick.
Picks up Alicia again. More Germans.
Oh, this is
nine German suplexes.
And all right to the head.
Whoa!
Nine German suplexes. None of them are
wait a second! She got it! Another heart attack!
It has to be over.
One! Two! No! It's not over!
You should be able to get the shoulder up. That's three heart attacks.
Jesus. Like I said, these women, including Alicia, are no slouches.
Yeah, it's like HitKid said. They are both very stubborn.
Stubborn as fuck.
Oh my goodness!
One, two!
That's gonna do it!
That is huge!
That is a big time victory for one Alicia Schultz!
It's a fucking head off, ladies and gentlemen.
Jesus Christ. It took like nine suplexes and three heart attacks. That didn't get the job done. That took like two kicks to the head.
No, it took one. She tried to go. She went for it earlier, but missed. But as soon as she caught her flush, she knocked her the hell out.
Indeed.
That's the most legitimate win of Alicia Schultz's career.
And still the TPGW Genesis champion, Alicia.
And with that kick in her arsenal, that it could just lead to more victories along the way.
Indeed.
That's the biggest win in Alicia Schultz's career. By and none.
Absolutely. Congratulations to Alicia Schultz for a successful defense of the Genesis title.
Congrats.
For the fix in the carnage.
Send in the clown! Apocalypse War!
Oh, I am the third.
Is it an actual? It's an actual big pack!
It's the drizzles.
Before I was so rudely interrupted, we're back!
You did not turn that well whatsoever.
Lucky. Interrupt me, you son of a bitch! We got TPGW Diamonds Tag Title Competition up next now. We saw the Anti-Empire come out for the first match where Kitty White won the Intercontinental Championship, and now they got another chance to put more belt into that stable as here comes Devil Jin and Kirara, Satan's Ballroom.
Oh, Jesus. We've seen these two before. Might I just say it's...
All members of the anti-fucking empire. Yeah.
Yes.
Let's be clear, Satan's Ballroom was already bad enough when they were just Satan's Ballroom, but now with the help with Beryl and Kitty, This whole thing seems it's about to get a lot worse before it gets any better. Mm-hmm. We already saw Alicia just a few moments ago, as now we got the rest of the Schultz's.
Here comes Mikasa and Tira. Tira.
I'm thinking of
Tira because of shit which has recently gone down in my account.
The Vixens of Carnage.
Speaking of which, that reminds me, I need to be at your next Fantasy Wrestling Acclaim show.
Oh yeah, the quarterfinals are taking place that run.
In particular, I need to see your management.
Yeah, that's true. But now, more on that later. Tia Schultz and Mikasa, very formidable tag team to say the very least. I know Tia Schultz.
I did see. I think we all know about Tia's condition and all that. How she's, you know, been, you know, resting
right.
and all that.
Yeah.
I think the question is, what shape is Mikasa in?
As we all know, Mikasa's been having she's been having a tough time as of late would probably be the biggest understatement of the year so far, and we are only about 17 days in. But Mikasa Schultz, she has been cleared to compete. She is going to compete. She's going to help help her aunt defend the tag team championship, but you bring a very good point. Is this going to be a case of where she could be 100% focused in on this match?
Yeah, that's a good question. Yo.
Introducing the challengers, the team of Devil Jet and Hero, Satan's Ballroom. And their opponents, they are the TPGW Diamonds Tag Team Champions, Tia and Mikasa Schultz, the Vixens of Carnage.
Here we go.
Mikasa went up against Kirara on an edition of Arena, where Kirara won that match, which gave Satan's Ballroom this shot here tonight. Is Mikasa going to be here enough mentally and physically to help win, to help defend those Diamonds Tag Team titles?
I mean, Mikasa, who's been through the fucking ringer, thanks to one really again.
Yeah.
Julia? The Joker's daughter!
Yeah?
Yes.
Oh, do I want to make you happier right now? She's sacked in my company.
Oh, wonderful.
Damn it.
No! I
can only take it.
I don't want to say his name, but I know who it is.
One.
That showed this voting. Super kick.
So she sang. She's gonna go at it with Jill Valentine on the show, which may or may not be out by the time you've watched this, Diamonds.
Oh, that's just wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
As now you got Kirara tagging into Devil Jin here. And now double back on.
Okay, can I be completely honest? Even though I'm not particularly fond of Satan's Ballroom, I'm. This might sound a little guilty, but I kind of like Kirara's hairstyle. That's just me.
Kirara is a woman that knows her style, and I'm not saying that because she is a giant woman who could probably crush me without a second thought in the world. That is very true.
Yeah, I did.
Tia looking right down to Kirara. She does not care.
Oh, we know about it.
Wait a second. It's Irish Curse Backbreaker!
Big time Irish Chris Blackbreaker.
As now, I'm letting the production truck know that they have a very sick mind and they need therapy. Oh, wait a second. Kirara! German suplex! From the giant woman herself.
Indeed.
The only people who have that mind are your headquarters. Although they have every character.
What?
Wait, you said she's a giant, right? Are you sure? I mean, she does look pretty tall, but...
Pretty big! Pretty big!
Good point.
You can step on you,
Alan. I'd rather have her not. I have one giant piston.
Oh, my goodness!
Double back suplex. Yeah, my God.
Listen, so how you get stepped on all the time? I have it from time to time, but currently I'm not really getting involved. Me and my girl currently, how do we put this? Focused on other issues if we get the right now.
I don't have a choice within getting stomped on.
Pretty much my girl's currently right now focused on withering of rolls. Nice drop kick.
Right,
I understand.
That will Jay now go for the cover! Right here!
No, one.
One count. Coming right after. Oh my goodness gracious!
Well, it's been a hell of a night here, this title.
Call me Kurt Angle as Devil Jin walks in the ankle lock here in the middle of the ring!
Call me Kurt Angle ankle lock.
Call Kirk Angel.
Isn't the Wonder Woman title in the madhouse?
Kirara's just not learning her lesson here!
Kirara's going up to the wall, she'll just pay attention to the team of advantage.
Necrica from the top right.
Kirara though was, ladies and gentlemen, like Wally Coyote with the Road Warrior.
Yeah, that didn't work out too well for her then.
Everything she tried always fails, if we can be clear.
Well, it's back to a vertical base now. And it's not going for Tia!
And the only good news was it didn't end up with her taking him like a massive hole.
Getting dropped on her neck wasn't too ideal either. Wait, what the hell?
Oh, what's she going for?
She's not
She saw it get in.
She got in!
Tag in the Devil Jin.
And Tia wants some more of Devil Jin! She took a single leg drop kick and gave it right back to her this time to the jaw. Twist of fate!
Planted.
And now...
for the Schultzes.
And her sights!
Face clean off.
Right in the face like she was Kawada.
Oh, Mochizuke.
That too.
Whoa!
Irish Curse! Devil Jade in the corner. Lighting her up. Rocket can go.
Missed it.
Wait a minute! Total elimination!
side effects.
Oh, Kirara. Even that big lady hit tag to Tia Schultz. Tia Schultz will like, you know, Kirara.
Learned her lesson.
But right now there's a tag.
Well, she doesn't have much of a choice here, as now Kirara looking. Send her back into the corner. Tag out.
Following contest scheduled for one fall is a no-holds-barred match, and it's for the TPGW Renegade Championship.
As you can feel the sort of uneasiness.
You felt cold here.
That was creepy.
The crowd as here comes Siniya Anex. One of the newer faces to the Diamonds division, whose whole mystique we still have not been able to figure out, other than the fact that she appears to be a witch, and that when she gets into the ring and has a match, strange things happen.
Well, this is the epitome of strange, this match we've got on deck.
We've got a witch and a zombie going at it for a title here in TPGW.
That sounds like the start of a bad joke.
This sounds like New Dawn.
Hello. Oh god, Roman's here.
Hello, Roman.
Roman.
Don't ask how I got in here. Just proceed. Don't.
I'll believe you.
Siniya Anex, I believe, made quite the impact back at Revolution when she actually beat Jennifer Kroll in her match. Even though, again, there was a bit of shenanigans involved in that whole ordeal.
Understatement.
But, you know, it's kind of like, it kind of fits here because it's a Renegade's title match, which I believe there are no rules in a Renegade title match.
I wouldn't believe so.
I don't believe there's any rules, so we're going to let him go.
I gotta admit, this might be, she might be a little spooky, but her music is very soothing.
Very relaxing.
I don't know what's going to be soothing about a witch and a zombie about to kill each other.
It's the calm before the storm.
It really is.
This match just brings the Rule 34
fetish artist in the rest of the night. All right, get out of here. Turn off your mic. Turn off his mic right now.
Wait. I just realized, witch versus zombie. A weekday for Sahaya, considering his own life.
Why do you think I made that joke?
All right.
You know, I'm like Sahaya. And... I mean, your wife is a combination of both of these things, plus being a vampire.
It's just got cold again.
Your
got
wife does
again.
Look extra thick. I'm just saying.
As here comes the TPGW Renegade Champion, Mello Cross.
Here comes Mello.
Yeah, dead person.
Mello, I have never seen the light of day Cross.
Mello Cross has always been a woman that's been around in virtual wrestling feds. You gotta think WFS, TPGW, but she's never had that big moment. She never had that big opportunity until Revolution when she won the TPGW Renegade Championship. I believe in a ladder match where I don't think anybody called her actually winning that match.
I don't believe any of you. I would though. So you tell me.
I don't believe anybody on the call.
I was still recovering, you know, from this, from leg, if I'm allowed to say it.
Right.
I've still got a couple of pins in this leg, as you know.
It's my first season doing commentary here. So I want to know.
Mello Cross, she got her moment, she got her opportunity at Revolution, and she capitalized big time. But now, just like how we have mentioned with Alicia, this is the big one. She's got to defend the belt. There's one thing to win it, it's a whole different animal when you have to defend it against anyone and everyone, especially when that anyone is a damn witch!
Disdain in Zahiah's voice.
Let's just go down to ringside.
Introducing the challenger emerging from the Ballybilly Forest of Ireland, the Darkness of Siniya, Anex! And her opponent, from Dusseldorf, Germany, she is the TPGW Renegade Champion, Mello Cross!
Renegade Championship on the line. The Zombie versus the Witch.
Renegade Championships, also known to be one of the more chaotic types of settings here.
Unholiness on display, ladies and gentlemen.
TPGW, so this fits this unholy battle which we are about to see right now between Siniya Anex and Mello Cross for the Renegade title.
Oh, right at the back. Cross with the punch. Whoa.
Siniya doesn't seem to be fazed.
She's telling her to bring it. Yeah, she is unfazed.
Siniya doesn't seem to be too weary about these punches here from Mello Cross. And it seems that she is inviting these. Oh, goodness!
Oh. Jesus Christ.
She actually rocked Mello with those straight jabs. And now Mello once more!
Jesus
Christ. Oh my
god. It's gonna get ugly.
Neither one of them are falling.
Yeah. Also, oh
wait,
she
got her by the hair. She got her by the hair. Oh!
Straight up just punches her in the face.
Janaya going off the ropes, but Mello cross catching her with the ring around neck break. Yes, thank you.
Hey, Mello cross.
Whoa.
Kick.
Have to do it. Like, it's not in your contract.
But he likes doing it.
No!
Kick again.
Calf kick! Oh!
Not even a one.
It's kind of what it's expected. Mello crosses the damn zombie. You gotta do a little bit more than that. Zendaya trying to put the dragon sleeper here.
Full dragon sleeper.
Also, really says something when Mello cross. I mean, no. Oh, wait a second. What? Apparently, we got a message from one. I'm getting confirmation that we're getting a message from Miss one Miss Holly Harris.
Oh my god!
Language and Cross got the sledgehammer.
Right now. After Mello was trying to get the sledgehammer.
That's right, what's she looking at? Steel chair.
Zendaya's got the steel chair in hand.
Got the chair.
Oh, and
Mello,
there it goes.
I get the fuck out.
She had the chair. Thanks, dude.
Hello. All right.
Apparently, this is from Miss Molly Harris herself. Aaron Michaels is now contractually obligated to scream neck breaker upon every neck breaker per MVP.
Yay.
I don't know how the hell she got that added into the fucking contract within a minute, but you know.
I'm just happy that's never been added to my contract.
Oh. No!
A glass handle from the pass. Hey, what's she doing?
I have no idea, and I'm kind of. Holly says don't. Oh my goodness! Holly says don't tempt her, HitKid.
Yeah.
As now Mello Cross delivering those steel chair shots to Siniya Anex after dropping her on her head.
Oh! Right in the arm. Oh, reverse.
Cameraman getting really up and personal with this action right now.
Yeah. At least he's not getting up and personal with.
No!
Oh.
What's that part, Aaron?
I don't want to face that.
What other parts are you talking about?
For assets. Double gut check.
At least he's honest. At least he's honest.
I mean, wouldn't be the first time we get a cameraman to take a photo of a girl's ass.
Ah!
Hello, the new Dom Pro Perfect cameraman.
Oh, wait a minute. What the hell is Siniya doing? Right? Up on the rip! Oh, my!
It's been a powerbomb onto the LED entrance. Yeah.
Goodness gracious!
Jesus Christ.
You gotta really put this in perspective here. Siniya just had her debut match at Revolution.
Hello.
That was her first match. And now in her second match, she has a chance to win the Renegades title. Now, both of these women up near the ramp here. Oh my gosh!
You don't get the second person we've seen thrown off the ramp tonight.
Oh no! Mello Cross is moving.
Oh, zombies don't die unless you blow the brains out.
Or their hearts.
Nah, you gotta go. You gotta go for their head.
Double tap. Oh, it's only your zombie land rules.
When has taking out a zombie's heart ever stopped a zombie?
I can't remember.
They're already undead. They can't be any more undead. Oh, I'm sorry. This is actually her third match. She beat Jane Hawk out in the arena.
Not let that zombie bite you.
We're not in the crowd, Arin, so I think you will be fine.
I'm talking to the crowd when I said that. Because one, there's a zombie. She's fighting a bit. There's a zombie and a witch going on.
Listen, to the fans in attendance, don't end up deader than the New England Patriots in this year's NFL playoffs.
Damn it.
And I just pissed off the city of Boston.
Jesus.
It's only a matter of time before a hit ultimately gets us banned from every city and every state ever made.
To be fair, Boston, that's their payback when they dumped all your team.
Oh, man.
Jesus Christ. Oh, my! Oh, no!
Oh, my.
Siniya.
Oh no. What's Cross doing? Hey, what's he doing?
Cross now!
Not on the chair!
Nothing but pain. A whole lot of pain.
I don't think she can get the victory here. I don't think it's false count anywhere, but that did a lot of damage.
Okay.
And I think Mello Cross is now realizing she's got to get her back inside the ring to finish this match off.
Whoa. Oh, tosses her back in.
We got this match, and we still got our main event, our champion versus champion match between Toni Storm, the Diamonds World Champion, and Queen of Carnage Champion, Jennifer Cool, coming up after this.
The main event is on deck or next, though.
Just toss it back in the ring.
And now Mello Cross could be looking to finish this one off here. Siniya is pretty much dead to right.
I was looking
right
to really put this away.
Whoa, no, she blocked it!
Got it from behind!
Wait, what the?
What was that? What the hell was that?
You want to know something? Because she's a witch, I'm not going to call that a crossroads. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the turning of the night. She calls it the Corduroy's Calling.
We got a champion!
The Renegade title.
Siniya Anex in her third match here in TPGW has just won a belt!
The irony of the turning of the night, the very thing that allows her to win a championship.
Oh, that's a bad camera.
Thank you, Ed.
Wow.
I'm not wrong.
Don't call it the cameraman.
Siniya Anex hitting Calderon's Calling to win not only her third match in TPGW history, but I believe in virtual wrestling history, she's the new Renegade champion.
Here is your winner and the new TPGW Renegade Champion, Siniya Anex.
Siniya Anex going titleless, to say the least. Go ahead, you're saying, Roman?
No, I don't like this. Nope, I don't trust that. Why she's letting the blue light loose?
Knock, knock. Open the door. It's new tag team champion time. Satan's Ballroom, the Anti-Empire, we have finally arrived. We slayed Akira, Kitty slayed Ivy, Beryl's gonna slay Celeste, no doubt in our minds. So to the women across the virtual wrestling, don't test your luck when Satan's Ballroom starts to slade.
It is now time for our main event of the evening, as now we are being put right into the fucking panic room!
Tonight's main event is a champion versus champion match, scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Moscow, Russia, she is the Queens of Wrestling Tartarus champion, the Dominatrix, Jennifer Crew.
The Queen
time.
The Queens of Wrestling Tartarus champion, as well as a former TPGW Diamonds World Champion in her own right, none other than the Dominatrix, Jennifer Cool.
I've seen this woman in action. She is certainly no slouch in the ring.
She's top of the line here.
Yep.
So who is this woman?
Yeah.
But you want to talk about top of the line, here comes the top dog.
And her opponent, one of those wins in Australia, she is the TPGW Diamonds World Champion, Toni Storm.
The woman that recently gave the biggest middle finger to the biggest wrestling company in the world, the current TPGW World Women's Champion, Toni fucking Storm is in the building.
Toni fucking Storm.
Toni walked out on them much like the automobile industry walked out on Detroit.
Not wrong.
Who's doing the gimmick?
Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event. Four Diamonds 18, the Holy MATTrimony. It is a champions versus champion match as the current Queens of Wrestling Tartarus champion Jennifer Poole picks on the current TPGW Diamonds World Champion Toni fucking Storm.
This is gotta be good. Oh, I'm good.
There's a lot of stake here considering Toni Storm has been tied by a very certain Black Widow.
Yeah, it was after her match back at the Christmas special where she was confronted by one Osenko who made her debut here for TPGW.
Yeah, that was fucking
most
amazing.
Interesting.
That was fucking amazing, to say the least.
Oh! Oh, wait a second. Not her debut.
She made an appearance.
An appearance.
Oh.
Oh, wait a second. Jennifer already has Toni in the tree of Joey Lawrence.
Oh.
Why do you call it that?
The what?
The tree of Joey Lawrence. Go, whoa. What? No. However, I have been told it was not a debut, but there are currently talks about Osenko here at TPGW. So.
Rumor has it that these two might be in a match in the future.
The rumor mill, the dirt sheets.
It toss.
Right.
You mean the gossip columns?
Fightful is reporting that Osenko might be on her way. Oh my gosh, German suplex.
How long till they report another release?
Here in TPGW? Man, that's gonna be weird. I'll just do releases again, and you'll just never see or hear that fucking person on my show again. Oh! Hello, John Cena.
Meanwhile, we got Toni Storm over here with him. Jennifer in the corner.
Oh!
Have to go to hospital. Oh, here we go, another one.
Go to hospital too! Tag. Can we say that now?
I'm saying that. I don't care if Malika's from there.
Alright, whatever.
If Malika's royalty, he can take his check, gonna hook you with it. Oh. Who else has shotgun me?
Oh, I thought that was a close line.
Toni Storm beat Charlotte back at Revolution 5 to claim that Diamonds World Championship, thus claiming the top dog spot here in the Diamonds division. However, you gotta believe the former top dogs don't take too kindly for that. Oh, what's that gonna be? Out of nowhere! One, two! The former top dogs of this division can't take too kindly to that, and they are looking to challenge Toni Storm in any way, shape, or form.
Watch out.
Storm! Zero! One! Two! No, I got it!
Wolfers and gentlemen!
No, I got it!
One's alright. One, two's alright. One, two's.
Oh! Big time kick to the head. Oh, now Jennifer Cole looking for that Dragon Sleeper again. She's too close to the ropes.
Oh, Cole could be going for it.
Oh, she's looking for the panic, bro. No! Toni gets out of it, and now Toni Storm with the Arin Crash Neckbreaker!
One, two.
Oh my god!
And it's over.
Oh my goodness, she got her!
Yeah, she insta killed her.
That was quick. I wasn't expecting that.
Toni! Go ahead.
Toni Storm with the absolute swiftness! The Arin Crash Neckbreaker gets the job done, and she picks up a big victory over Jennifer Cruel.
You gotta be thinking Jennifer Cruel is salty after the result.
I mean, what really does she have to be salty about? She challenged Toni Storm, and she
lost.
Can't handle her.
That's the same Arin Crash Neckbreaker that she used to beat Charlotte back at Revolution, and again, turns out to be the big money move for Toni Storm. There you can see hitting it one more time. Toni Storm wins this champion versus champion match.
Here's your winner, Toni Storm.
Oh, by the way, we forgot to do this.
Nyakbrika.
All right. Nyakbrika. For Zahiah Morgan, for Aaron Michaels, for Roman Bedlam, for HitKid. This has been Diamonds! And we'll see you next time!